Dear friends, good morning. Today we are going to discuss the issue of shares, second segment that deal with the share capital. The share capital of the company is divided mainly in five categories, such as authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, and paid up capital. Friends, as far as authorized capital is concerned, the amount of capital which the company is authorized to raise by its memorandum of association and with the company registered with the register of companies, that capital is known as the authorized capital or the registered capital. In other words, it is also known as the nominal capital. For example, the authorized capital of rupees 50 lakhs divided into 50,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. The second category is issued capital. Friends, it is that part of authorized capital which is issued to the public for subscription and to vendors in case of purchase of a business or the assets. For example, out of 50 lakhs or out of 50,000 shares, the company may issue only 25,000 shares to the public in case the issued capital is 25,000 shares of rupees 100 each. Automatically, it is 25 lakhs. Okay. Next category is subscribed capital. It is that part of issued capital which is taken up or purchased by the public. Friends, many times the public may purchase entire issued capital or sometime the less than the issued capital. If entire capital is subscribed, automatically the subscribed capital is 25,000 shares of rupees 100 each, it is 25 lakhs. However, if it is only the public is applied for the 24,000 shares only, automatically the subscribed capital will be 24,000 shares of rupees 100 each and it is the 24 lakhs. Okay, next, called up capital. Dear friends, though the shares are of rupees 100 each, the company may not call full amount of rupees 100 per share during the allotment or from the subscriber or from the shareholders, those who are applying for the shares. The company may demands only that portion of value of shares which may be as the allotment money or first call. Suppose company is decided that application money rupees 20, allotment money rupees 20, and first call is rupees 25, automatically the called up capital is rupees 65, that 20 plus 20 plus 25, rupees 65 per share, it is known as the called up capital. And finally, the paid up capital. Friends, paid up capital is an important aspect, because we shown the paid up capital in the balance sheet in the outer column. Therefore, everybody should understand what is the paid up capital. If called up capital is fully paid or actually paid, actually been paid by the shareholders, automatically called up capital is also treated as the paid up capital. However, sometime the shareholders may pay the portion of called up capital, and therefore we can treat as it is that portion of the called up capital which has actually been paid by the shareholders, as it is likely that some shareholders may not fail the amount demanded and due on their shares. It is known as they fail, some shareholders can fail to pay the valid calls made by the company. It is the unpaid, and therefore by for showing the paid up capital, automatically that calls in arrears or which amount the shareholders are not paid is deducted, and finally we can show the paid up capital in the balance sheet. Friends, in addition to this, we should know the concept of reserve capital under the share capital. Reserve capital represents the portion of the subscribed capital which has not been called up, and which the company by special resolution had decided not to call, except in the event of or for the purpose of the winding up. Thus, the share capital is having these five categories, and additional category is the reserve capital. As far as reserve capital is concerned, try to understand it. The company may pass the special resolution and decided that not to call off except in the event of or for the purpose of winding up, and this reserve capital is kept by passing the special resolution by the board of directors of the company. Okay, and therefore in the balance sheet we can show as authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, and if subscribed capital is fully called, automatically subscribed and called up is equal. Many times just we discussed all the called up capital that we can't show in the outer column of the balance sheet, because there may be the calls in arrears, and therefore called up capital minus calls in arrears, that amount is what arises after deducting the calls in arrears, that we can show in the outer column of the balance sheet. Dear friends, next aspect, that process of issue of shares. Try to understand it. Share can be issued at par, at a discount, or at a premium. When the face value of share is equal to issue price, it is known as the shares are issued at par. It means, suppose the face value of share is rupees 100 and issue price is rupees 100, automatically it is treated as the shares are issued at par. Many times the management can issue the shares at a discount. It means the issue price is less
than the face value. Suppose the issue price per share is rupees 92 and face value is rupees 100, automatically we can say the discount of 8 rupees is given. However, during given the discount, whatever the provisions are given in the Company Act, it is to be taken into account. In addition to this, the company can issue the shares at a premium, means the issue price is more than the face value. Many times the face value is rupees 100 per share and shares can be issued for rupees 105 per share. In this case, rupees 5 is additional, it is treated as the premium, and for that premium the accounting treatment is given separately as a share premium. Friends, in this term, the accounting treatment during issue of shares at par, issue of shares at a discount, issue of shares at a premium, that we can discuss in detail during the accounting treatment for the various transaction in issue of shares. Now, it is that everybody should know that what is the first step in issue of shares. A public limited company issue the prospectus and appeal the public to subscribe to its share capital, the intending the shareholders them to apply in the prescribed form for the number of shares that they are interesting to take with the application money. The application money per share that payable with the application that are given in the prospectus, and issue during the issue the prospectus giving an information to the interesting investors for applying the share or share capital. Today we are concluding this segment here. Thank you very much.